Hello guys, we are back with our next set of tutorials. In this tutorial, let us start the 8255A guys. It is a programmable interface, programmable peripheral interface. So this chapter consists of different interfaces guys. So this chapter totally consists of almost 6 to 7 different types of peripheral interfaces for which you need to learn your pin diagram, architecture diagram and about the description. So this chapter is a bit complex when you compare with other chapters. So now let us start 8255A in this tutorial. We'll be ending 8255A in this tutorial itself. Fine. So 8255A. Intel 8255A is a programmable peripheral interface, that is nothing but PPI, also known as programmable interface adapter, that is nothing but PIA. It is a 40 pin IC guys. This pin diagram is really easy guys. I'll be just saying you a trick so that you can even remember it really easily. Okay, this is a programmable input output device that can be used within almost any microprocessor guys. You can connect this device to any microprocessor as per your need. It is very powerful and a complex design. This is the small drawback of this. It's a bit complex. Okay, so now let us go through some features of 8255A. So it has 40 pins that we have discussed previously. Yes, it is a programmable parallel IO device. Okay, it is an IO device that is compatible with all microprocessors. This is a good news to hear guys. Fine. It has three modes: mode 0, mode 1 and mode 2. Mode 0 is simple IO, mode 1 is a strobed IO mode, mode 2 is a bidirectional port. Fine. So I hope everyone got a small idea on all the three modes. Further moving on, port C can be mode 0 only. Port C. So there are three ports also guys in this. So port C will be only mode 0, where port B will be mode 0 and mode 1. Port A will be the combination of three. So only this will be there in C, including these two will be there in B, including these three will be there in A, in that format guys. In that format the ports will be working. So once you are going through the diagrams, you will be having a small idea on this. So now first let us go through the pin diagram guys. I think I can zoom it. Okay, fine. I'll be holding my phone like this for a while. Okay, fine. 8255A. Okay, let me place a book, guys, so that it will be convenient for me and for you also. Okay, fine. It's 100% perfect now. Is that? Yes. So, initially, you need to remember three numbers, guys. Fine. You need to remember three numbers to remember 8255A diagram. So, the numbers are 4. You need to remember them in order also guys, that's the main problem. 4, 18, 15. These are the three numbers you need to remember. So just take assumption of your class roll numbers. That's the reason how I remembered these things. So assume those three are going to a movie or going to somewhere and just make a statement like that. And you can just remember it. Fine. So at pin 4, start writing PA naught and write it in the up direction guys. That is nothing but PA naught at 4, PA 1 at 3, PA 2 at 2, PA 3 at 1, PA 4 at 4 is 40, PA 5 at 39, PA 6 at 38, PA 7 at 37. So we are done with this U shape guys now. Fine. So similarly at 18 PB0. So here it is 18, so write it down guys. PB0, PB1, PB2, PB3, PB4, PB5, PB6. So here also we made a U shape. Or even you can remember that from top the third will be, sorry, from top the fourth will be PA0 and from bottom the third will be PB0. Like that also you can remember, it's all up to you guys. So now we are done with this also. This consists of PB0 in the down direction. Further moving on at 15. So this is a bit crazy thing guys. So at 15 we'll be having PC0. Initially it goes down and then it initially comes up. In this way. PC0. Okay. Then PC2, PC3, PC4, PC5, PC6. Okay guys, so now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So Just give me a second, guys. I'm a bit confused. Okay, that it's correct only. But where is PC 1? Okay, just give me a second, guys. I'll be back in a moment. Okay, guys, in PC, we'll be not having PC 1, maybe, guys. That's the reason why I searched online also. But in every diagram, the diagram is similar to this. And I was unable to find PC 1 in that. So, at 15, we'll be starting PC 0. Then we'll be writing PC 2, PC 3. And we move up. After there is no chance to move down, right? So, we will be moving up. PC4, PC5, PC6 and PC7. There we will be ending it. And after that we will be writing out two address line, 2 bit address, that is nothing but A0 and A1. Then we didn't give any power supply, right? So we will be writing VSS and ground. Those two are nothing but in some cases they will be calling as ground, but I call them, one is power supply and the other one is ground. Fine. Above that we will be writing chip select and read operation, guys. So whenever we are writing chip select, read and write will be in a similar place, but here as the place is not sufficient, chip select, read and write will be traveled towards the other side. Fine. So below that you will be writing reset, and after that you will be writing your 8 data lines and then the VCC, the power supply. That's it, guys. So if you practice this diagram twice or thrice, you can easily remember that, guys. Okay. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on that. So now let us go through the block diagram. Guys, if you want to find these diagrams, you just go to Google and type the diagram name. That will be in front of you, guys. Okay, I think this is not at all clear. So let me grab my book. I think it's in my book. Okay, just give me a second, guys. I'll be back in a second. Hello, guys. I'm back. So this is the block diagram of 8255, guys. So the main thing that you should remember is it has two groups and three ports, guys. So group A and group B are the two groups, where port A, port B and port C are the three ports. So basically group A has group port A and port C upper, and group B has port C upper and port B. Fine. Okay. So initially draw those things, two boxes, four boxes. Connect this to a data bus or some kind of bus, and that connect to group A port A, and the other direction you connect to group A port C upper. That is nothing but you can just write it like this: PA7 to PA0, here input output PC7 to PC4, as it is upper. So from group B you will be having an access to group B, port C lower, that is nothing but IO PC3 to PC0. Fine. So next, group B control goes to group B port B, IO input output PB7 to PB0. Okay, guys. So now I hope everyone is now 100% clear with the connection still here, guys. So this side we'll be having a data bus. As usual, for every block diagram we need a data bus. So the data bus, and we also need the read write logic. That's what written here. Read write A1 and A2 will be the address, reset will be to make it zeros. So CS is nothing but chip select. It should always be active to make the microprocessor work. So I hope everyone got a small idea on all the parts of this block diagram. So if you want, you can just Google it, guys. Go to Google, type 8255A block diagram, and you'll be getting a result like this. This is what I got. So that's the reason why I kept that. I thought it would be clear, but it's not at all clear, guys. Fine. So now let us go through individual pins of 8255A. The pins from PA0 to PA7 and B PB0 to PB7 and PC0 to PC7. We'll be discussing about these first. So these are the 8-bit bidirectional IO pins. These are used to receive data from input output devices and send data. Fine. So among these two are really common, they are similar, but when we come to PC0 to PC7, they break into two, right? So higher and lower. Fine. So there is a special thing in that. PC0 to PC3, these are used for handshaking signals when program for handshake. So when there are any kind of interaction between the interfaces, the process called handshaking comes into play, in which the data buses will be handover and some kind of issues like that, guys. Okay, fine. So PC4 to PC7, these are the four IO pins, are used also in the same way for handshaking, guys. Whereas these are the higher bits, those are the lower bits. Fine. So A0 to A1, A0 and A1, those are nothing but the two address lines. RD bar read operation, WR bar write operation, CS chip select, that should always be 1 to activate the working of R8255A, reset a high logic input on this signal, clears the control registers. Yeah, that's what I have told. The operation will not be done, it becomes a zero directly. D0 to D7, that is an 8-bit data line which can transfer 8 bits at a time. Okay, so till here we are done with our pin configuration. So now let us go through the parts of block diagram. So read write control logic. To control the logic section accepting the control bus signal, CS should be active low. That is nothing but it is CS bar, right? CS bar. So it should be 0. Then it is indirectly CS equal to 1. So it is active in that situation. Fine. So RD is nothing but read signal, WR is nothing but write signal, reset. These all things we discussed in the previous thing itself, and we also have the data bus buffer. It takes 8 bits from D0 to D7. Guys, while you are writing like that, please indicate these blocks also, guys. Group B having this as input, this as output, and this is a part of group A is divided into two parts like that. Just draw them and define them so that it looks really good. So I hope everyone got a small idea on 8255A. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through serial data transfer or serial communication. Thank you. Thanks for watching.